Alright guys, so now I want to talk about what I would consider the most confusing term of the Gibbs free energy equation, and that is entropy. Alright, so entropy, generally stated, we said that it was a measure of disorder in the system, okay? But that's a really confusing definition. I would rather go with an easier definition, okay? And what that is that entropy is the tendency of a system to take its most probable form, okay? So that means that if we have two different states, one is highly ordered and one is not as ordered, statistically, it's more likely to be in the disordered state, okay? And that's what entropy has to do with. It has to do with probability, really, okay? So what that means is that even if a reaction is highly exothermic, like if you talk about bond association energies and enthalpy, that has to do with exothermic. But the level of order that it requires might make it statistically improbable, okay? So basically what we do with entropy is we have to analyze, is this going to be statistically more probable or statistically less probable? And that is what entropy is, okay? Remember that we defined that entropy says that a negative value is going to be more ordered, okay? Because remember that basically a positive value means that it's more disordered. That means that your entropy is getting bigger. So if you have a negative value, that means your entropy is getting smaller or it's getting more ordered, okay? And it turns out that we're never going to have to calculate the entropy in terms of calculating the entropy of the surrounding environment or the entropy of a system because of the fact that we don't have really the tools to analyze that in Orgel 1, okay? But what you are going to be asked to do, okay, is you're going to be asked to analyze if something is going to have a positive delta S or negative delta S. And that's what we want to do. We don't want to figure out the exact number. We just want to figure out, is this going to be higher entropy or lower entropy? Okay. Now, there is one situation where you might calculate delta S, and that's if you're given every other variable. If you're given the T and the delta H and the delta G, then sure, you could just use algebra to figure out delta S. But I'm just saying that in the absence of this being just a simple algebra problem, you're not going to be asked just to calculate what the delta S is of an environment, okay? So let's talk about these three phenomena that make reactions more probable or make delta S go up. And it turns out that all of them are going to be favored by high temperature, okay? So that should be really clear in a little bit when I go back to the equation.